Oh, there's already some people here.
Am I early? No, right on time.
Okay, we have 6 people. Hi, you guys. Let's see this again. Alright, let's see. Hey there. Hey Kevin. Hey James. You just have to dance with us. Because Jerome won't do it.
I'll do it.
Love the music. Yeah.
We're gonna do yoga, so
yoga.
We're gonna do yoga with bonsai trees.
Because it's gonna be alright. Alright. Loving the music, see? It's good pick. Alright.
I think we should get started.
Oh, we have 10 people now.
Let's do it, huh?
See? Bear with us, guys.
Just want to make sure everybody's locked in and ready to go.
Let's see. I think we're fine. So we're going to wait a few minutes.
You want to win them up?
Okay. I think it's fine.
All right, what's up, guys? Welcome to this live Q&A. As you guys know, this is Mari and I'm Jerome, of course. So welcome, guys. Hope you guys are well.
Yeah, you guys, if please tell us where you're from and if you are staying at home, if you are in a shutdown, lockdown, just staying safe. So yeah, send us in the message. We want to see where you guys are from and what's the situation. We all are dealing with this coronavirus, so.
It's a good time to work on your trees, though.
Yeah, it is. So we have Kevin from Michigan. Awesome, awesome. How's the situation out there? Oregon, awesome. Awesome, awesome, yeah. All right, well, we hope you guys are doing well. Orlando, Italy. Oh my gosh, we really, really hope you're doing great. I know, yeah. Italy. It's not doing too well. We hope you're safe. Fort Myers, not total lockdown, but hanging out at home mostly. Great. And I have been working on mine lately. Awesome. Mariana's Island.
Nice. Yeah. Near Guam.
That's my
welcome.
Mom's name, Mariana.
That is true.
The host day, oh really? The host day is closed down, huh?
Oh, wow.
Wow, Arizona, self-imposed lockdown, good. Hey, John, from Davey.
Who's that John guy?
Hey, John, I know you missed the store, we missed it too.
Yeah.
Still working, apparently our place is essential. Well, yeah, not everybody can really do this lockdown. It's complicated. Mark Gay, Florida, working on a FICA's Benjamina today.
Nice.
Yeah, so one of the things we had to do also was to close our store. So our location is closed momentarily, and we are encouraging everybody to stay at home. And we have this campaign, which is hashtag stay at home and bonsai. So so you guys, I know this time is hard and something to, you know, to distract yourself and to relax and just, you know, be connected with nature. And, you know, bonsai is great for that. And we hope you can take bonsai as a way to release the stress and to deal with this.
And if the bonsais don't work, hopefully our TikToks help you.
Yeah.
Her TikTok, she makes them. She's a TikTok creator.
Okay. Let's not talk about TikTok. That's desperate times. You know, you're desperate when you start doing TikToks.
That's right.
And that's us. So I wanted to tell you guys. Oh, well, let me read a little bit more.
Kelly right there. What's up, Kelly?
Got three bougainvilleas out of the trash after me and you talk.
You know, Kelly was actually one of the very first people to take our beginner's course at the old store.
Oh, yeah?
I think was like in the second class or third. Yeah.
Nice. Looking forward to my bonsai cypress and wisteria to bloom. Oh, yes. That's going to be beautiful. Love you guys doing your dance move on various TikToks. We definitely have a little extra time to do those things. Saludos desde Houston. Hola, Wicho Terán. And nice work, Mari and Jerome. Oh, thank you. All right, so you guys, we wanted to, you know, do this live Q&A so we can connect with you again. Obviously, these times are not the best times, but we're gonna go through this and everything's gonna be all right. So we just wanted to let you know in our campaign, hashtag stay at home and bonsai, we created these short courses, online courses. We have Jerome, we have Ed Trout and Adam collaborating with this. These short courses are very inexpensive. So it's just, they're $5 courses. And it's pretty much, we don't want to break anybody's bank at this time, but we want to keep working with bonsai. And one of the main things about bonsai is that every species is different. So we wanted to focus in a specific species. So this time around, this first month, we're gonna work with desert roses,
that's right,
jades, and bottomwoods. And when you get this course, you also get into a private closed Facebook group that is gonna be specific for that course and for that species. So you get to ask all the questions, or if you have any doubts on the content that the Ed and Jerome and Adam put together, you can go there and you can also share your own tree and ask for questions and feedback. So we wanna keep it with feedback.
It's
like a study group pretty much. And once again, this $5 courses is not like a monthly membership or anything like that. It's just a one-time thing. And you also have the option to do a one-on-one session, that's if you will. But just with the course, you get the closed Facebook group when we're gonna share a lot of insights about a specific species, and you can post your own trees and ask questions and just, you know, get the help from the ones that already have succeeded with those species. And that's what we wanted to focus on. These three guys have a lot of experience with those species. Jerome is doing the desert rose.
Yes.
Adam is doing the jade, and Ed is doing the bottomwood. So these guys put together all straight to the point, tricks, tips, what it works, what it doesn't with those species, so you can succeed with your bonsai. That's one thing. And we also have an Instagram giveaway. So I hope you're following us on Instagram. And if you are not, our Instagram is at thebonsaisupply.com. And in there, we're giving away three courses, three VIP courses, which it is that you get the one-on-one session with the artist. And all you have to do is to post a picture of either a jade or a buttonwood or a desert rose, and tag the Bonsai Supply, hashtag stay at home in bonsai. And you will be participating to win one of these prizes. We're gonna do this in 2 days now, so on the 27th.
Yeah.
We'll be announcing the three winners. So participate so you can win this course as well. You have the chance to win.
So the 101 is also gonna be online, of course.
So all of this for
now. So anybody in the entire world can participate with that.
Yeah. So
it's really cool.
It's not only for the US. I know sometimes they're always like, oh, but it's only the US, only the US. Now it's for everybody. Everybody mm-hmm. that is, they have access to a computer.
Yeah. And so there's also going to be a fresh material coming, of course. But for now, we have these three courses ready.
Yeah. Those are the ones we're going to start with, and trying to keep this guy motivated to keep writing and to keep sharing their knowledge. But we're going to start with those.
Yeah.
Yes. And the other thing, Jerome is going to have a styling wiring class that is also going to be done online. It's going to be done through Zoom. And it's limited to 8 people. He's going to do it for 3 Saturdays. And he's going to show you, you're going to show him your tree. And he's going to give you feedback, and you're going to wire it and style it with him, with his recommendations. And it's kind of like a face-to-face. Yeah. I don't know if you guys have used Zoom, but it's like a two-way, real-time conversation. So it's easier, and you can show your trees through the camera.
And you can also see the other people's trees that they bring, and you can learn from the feedback that they are getting. So that's a really helpful tool. And so that should be really cool. So we can all see each other and hear each other, so it's going to be awesome.
Yes. So let me start looking at the questions. And you guys, please feel free to start asking questions about the courses or about anything you would like to ask.
Somebody said, where can I find the courses, Kevin?
Okay.
I don't know if you said that.
Yes. The courses, if you guys go to our website, www.thebonsaisupply.com, you'll see the banner that says Bonsai Online Bonsai Bootcamp.
It has a glass of wine in the picture. It's hard to miss.
Yeah, so, right? So you can be at your home.
I think that's the first thing people will see.
A glass of wine.
Yeah,
so it's on our website. We're going to put the link on the description of this video as well, in case you wanted to see it later. What else? Hopefully some non-exotics. Okay.
Yeah.
What do you mean? By species?
So non-tropicals, yeah. Yeah, we're definitely working on that. So those are just the 3 species that we just chose that all of us are really comfortable with. And for me, adeniums, I get so many emails and questions every single day about adeniums. So I really wanted to clear all the questions and the confusions up of how to grow desert roses, when to repot them, when to defoliate, how to defoliate. All of that stuff, I just wanted to clear it up. And then, of course, as we progress, we're going to cover deciduous trees and everything, which we'll try to, hopefully.
Yeah. I mean, slowly but surely.
Absolutely.
We want to focus for sure on those that usually people ask for. Yeah, and the nice thing is the group, the Facebook group, mm-hmm. the closed Facebook group that you get to access with the course, because it's gonna be like a study group, and you're gonna focus on that species, and at the end that's the way to master bonsai. Every species is different, so if you can, you know, choose the ones that attracts you the most, and you can take them to the next level if you know really what it works and what it doesn't.
And you're also gonna learn from other people's, you know, that grow, for instance, a desert rose in a different climate that I wouldn't know about, but somebody in the group might know about specific. Trick about the desert rose. So that's where the group comes in really handy, and it's a really, really cool tool where we can all learn from each other.
Yeah. Yes. I'm reading here my dance moves are the ones that people think they're okay.
No. He says, well, but Mari's dance moves. That means that the dance moves are not really good.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That's how I read it.
Okay, hello from Annapolis, Elliot, hello, hello guys, oh, Charlie, hey Charlie,
hey Charlie,
how's it going, we miss you, $5, that's like 2 candy bars,
that's right, Michael,
that's right, that's what I said, so we hope you all take advantage of that, and we can keep, you know, this connection with you through a specific study and a little more, how do you say, like advanced or deep or just. Let's say hello from Colombia.
Hola.
Hola, Francisco. Y Francisco, si necesitas ayuda, yo traduzco, no te preocupes. Jerome no habla español, pero está aprendiendo y bueno.
No, más o menos, ¿no? Habla un poquito. That's all I got.
Hello from Germany.
Germany.
Okay, so you can
tell him your German word that you know. You don't remember from the show we watched? Polizei?
Oh, Polizei. Yes.
What show was that from?
That's it. I don't even remember.
That was a really good show. It was filmed in Germany. Anyway.
Yeah.
This is, we're talking about bonsai today.
Yes. in St. Michael. Not a bonsai question. How is the shutdown affecting the dog rescue you work with? Okay, so the rescue actually moved to a location. Like before, we were all volunteers and we didn't have like a location. Now the rescue has a location, and the location still works okay. They're just doing the meet and greets, kind of like they limit like the people at the same time. They're going, I mean, a little, they're just trying to be careful, but this is still going. In fact, we are getting a lot of people applying for dogs. We do see that there are people bringing dogs to the shelter because that this is something or like a rumor that the dogs could like transmit the virus or whatever.
One dog in China got
your dogs, their family. So I mean, it's like your kids. Anyway, I mean, the rescue's, you know, working as they can, but the volunteers are there, and that's been, I mean, great. Let's say, perfect. I'm a beginner, and I have jades and desert roses. Awesome.
Perfect.
We love them. They are so great species for bonsai. I mean,
definitely easy to get started with and be successful.
Yeah. And they grow fast, so you can see results, you know, quickly.
And they both flower depending on your location. Do you guys like starting with a do-it-yourself kit, like one that is almost ready to prune and pot, or buying nursery stock that might be a year or two away from first pruning, trying to start? When you start, I would say it's always easy with the tree that's already potted in a bonsai pot and already shaped, and maybe like a smaller tree. And you start out, you know, all these bonsai nurseries have those $30 trees that you can start out with, and they're already in good soil, they're already healthy. And I would start out with something like that. I would make sure that you go and support, you know, your local bonsai nursery or order a bonsai online. But what do you think? When you're a beginner and you start, how?
You know, I think it's personal preference. I know bonsai is about patience, but I'm not too patient. So I do not go with static kits myself. I wouldn't. Just because I just feel about the time, and I don't know, some people really like to see that from the beginning. Some people start from seeds, which I will never do.
Growing from seed is hard.
Yes.
Yeah. Especially most of the times the seeds are faulty, like they've already died. And so you're not going to be successful.
And it's really going to take a long time to become like something that, you know, I don't know. But it's personal preference.
It takes a long time. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's definitely true.
Yeah. This is Brandon. It's one of our rescue dogs. And
speaking of rescue dogs, you heard you, Michael.
Yeah.
I just want to show his face.
Yeah. It can be too far from us for too long. Let's say, what else do we have here?
I haven't done any wiring styling.
Cool. I haven't done any wiring styling.
Yeah, you should join us on Saturday.
Yeah, yeah, that's gonna be fun.
That's definitely gonna be good for you.
It's gonna be fun. And it's a small group, so it's gonna be fun. Let's say, what about honey planting seeds tomorrow? Oh, so you're one of the ones that use seeds. I don't know. I'm not really familiar. Are you familiar with that
species? I'm not familiar, but the one thing I do know, when you grow from seed, you can predict everything, and you can make what the Japanese would call a perfect bonsai, right? Because you can choose how you want the trunk movement to be, where you want the branches to be. So starting from seed, you can definitely make probably some of the most incredible bonsais, but it just takes forever. It takes a really long time, even in the tropics. I mean, I don't know if I ever grew anything from seed that I still have.
I mean, obviously, if you find joy in that,
sure, yeah, like absolutely,
it's completely okay too. Okay, so cute, Michael said. Yeah, Brandon is a cutie. Hi, doggy. Cuttings are a good way to start.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, as I said, if you can, and if you find a good material that is already a little more developed, I will encourage that, because you can play more with it. Like if you want to style the tree, wire the tree.
I guess it's a combination of how much space you have. Do you have a big backyard? Do you just have a small balcony? It depends on a lot of things. Like a lot of people like to start bonsai and they like to collect trees or start to air layer, which I personally really like a lot. And other people like to buy already finished stuff for pre-bonsai. So you can kind of start however you see fit. You know?
Yeah, there are many ways to enjoy
bonsai. That's a good thing about it.
To be honest.
Yeah.
Let's say, which species is beginner friendly for first season outdoor after 4 years of indoor seasons?
That really depends on where you live.
Let's say in Florida.
In Florida, I mean, buttonwoods, that's a good beginner tree because all it really needs is a lot of water. Brazilian rain tree is a good tree. Chibotacaba is a good tree. If you don't live in Florida, I would say a good beginner tree would probably be like an elm tree because they're really tough. Some maples can also be tough, so that could also be a good beginner species.
Okay, then Alex, is a tropical course on hold? It is.
Oh, what's up, Alex?
Hey, Alex. It is. We're trying to reschedule with Pedro.
So we are going to definitely have it, though.
Yeah, we're definitely going to have it.
We're just going to move the date.
Yeah, we were thinking in something like mixing virtual or online with it, so...
We're just waiting a little longer to see
what's
going to happen.
You know. Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll give you a post, Alex.
He can't wait for the tropical class.
I know. It's fun. But join Jerome this Saturday for the styling class. And then for the courses, we have Jade, Desert Roses, and Buttonwoods.
Yes.
All right. Let's say hello from Cleveland.
Hello.
Hi, Ron. What do I need to do for my azalea this time of the year?
Not much. I mean, you should have already repotted them. So I always know when it's spring, when I see the first, azaleas bloom, or like the dogwoods, or like the cherry trees. When I see those bloom, I know that it's spring, and that's when I know that it's too late to repot those species. But that also is an indicator that the window of the deciduous tree repotting is closing pretty fast, so you need to hurry up.
Yeah.
What you need to know about azaleas, I guess, is that they like acidic soil. We use Canuma a lot for azaleas because they like that. But you can also, if you don't use Canuma, you can just use a regular, like our soil mixture, and use an acidic fertilizer. It's perfect.
I love azaleas. Oh my gosh.
Oh, me too.
That's so beautiful. It says, do you guys mix your own soil or buy a pre-mixed bonsai blend?
So we actually, yes, we do make our own soil mixture. So we actually order all the soil, and it all comes from the United States. And most of the aggregates are being shipped from California all the way down to Florida. And then we have our soil Mali, as I like to call him. Sommelier. That's a hard word to say. I should practice. Is Jeffrey, and he puts all the soil mixes together. So he washes them, he double sifts them, he mixes them, and he bags them, everything. So, with help, of course, but he's the soil master, if you will.
Yeah. Talking about soil.
Yes. So, just so you guys know, Amazon is not allowing for anybody to ship any more non-essential things to the fulfillment centers. So we just ran out of the 5-gallon soil bags on Amazon today. But not to worry, we are offering them now on Etsy. So the way that you can find the soil bags is you go to our websites, you click on trees, and that will take you to our Etsy store. And there you can find our 2 quarts and our 20 quarts, which is the 5-gallon soil bag. And we'll ship it to you from the store. It might just take a couple days longer.
Yeah.
But just so you guys know, in case something is sold out that we sell on Amazon, we'll offer it on Etsy.
Yeah, you can get it from Etsy now.
Yeah.
And the big bag is still free shipping.
Yes.
And the other one, we did reduce the price, so the shipping can balance.
It's going to be the same like on Amazon at the end of the day, probably.
Yes. Okay, so you read this one from Roberts.
Out of 200 large seeds, only one germinated. It's not 18 months old and in a pond basket. It is now greening up nicely. Now it is spring.
It's
a statement. Okay. Yeah. So that's why I'm glad that you posted this, Robin, because I've tried to grow a lot of stuff from seed, like black pines are easy to grow from seed. And I sowed like 500 black pine seeds and only like 10 germinated. And that's a really low rate. So yeah.
Yeah, that's the magic of
seeds. Growing from seeds is cool.
I cannot read this. You're a true bonsai master.
Where do you read that?
No, wait, I need to read this. I love your videos and your wife is beautiful. This guy is very smart.
Justin,
you made my day.
And mine too.
All right, Carlos. I recently purchased a rain tree pre-bonsai. When trying to clip and grow the shade branches, should I wait until new growth hardens or clip while new growth is still soft and green?
So this is a very, very good question, actually. So he said that he just got a Brazilian rain tree pre-bonsai, and if he should clip it when the new growth is green or should he wait until it hardens? So you always, always want to wait until the new growth hardens and turns into wood. If you trim the green stuff off, like the fresh shoots, you're telling the tree not to grow, and the tree gets shocked a little bit. And then it tries to grow again, and then you trim it back again, you tell the tree again not to grow. And so if you do this a couple of times, over and over again, the tree gets very weak because it doesn't know what's going on, right? It's trying to grow, but you're telling it not to grow. So it gets very weak, and then that's how you end up with a weak bonsai. So always, always let your trees grow until the new growth turns to hard wood. And that's very, very important in the springtime. When the trees wake up from dormancy, let them push. Let them stretch their legs, so to speak. And just let them harden off, and then you trim them back. Very good question. Thank you.
All right. Francisco, what tree are good to start for beginners?
What trees are good to start for beginners? I would say any tropical tree is really good. Any tree is really...
You're in a tropical climate.
Yeah, but even if you're not, you can keep them inside. And, if you're in a tropical climate, tropicals, obviously. If you're in, like, Georgia or, like, the Carolinas, where you can still manage the tropicals. Otherwise, I would say, like, a deciduous, like, an elm is easy. Yeah. Or a maple. But I would not go with, like, a black pine or something like that. Even like a cherry tree, I know it's very appealing, everybody wants a cherry tree or a wisteria, but I would just wait with those species a little bit until you have the basics down, proper watering, proper feeding, and keep them insect free and pest free, and then you can venture out into different. But that's a very good question too, because every tree that you have is slightly different from each other, and some species vary greatly from each other, so you have to make sure that you get familiarized with each single tree that you have. And this is why on our online bootcamp, we focus on specific species. We give you everything you need to know about that specific species, because there's no such thing as like a general guidance on how you need to keep your trees.
Yeah. All right. I always recommend dates, no matter what. To me, are the best tree for beginners. They always gonna be, they're so easy to care for. They are fast growers. You can play with them. So you can propagate them.
Jades
so
are really easy, yeah.
Jades is always gonna be my go to for beginners.
Yeah.
What am I now? All right, saludos desde California. Hola, Manuel.
Hello, California.
Hello from Tampa. I was planning to go to your store, but postponed because of the emergency. I'm at home. Please keep the videos coming. Can't watch TV. It's too stressful. We feel you. Yeah, Emmanuel, if you can join the online courses, we're going to post a lot of stuff there. Also, we do have a group called the Bonsai Supply family, and that one is open to everybody. And there is just like a place to, you know, show your trees, ask for advice with other, with a community that's supportive.
Yeah.
So
and
if
that's
you
on
also
Facebook.
Wanna join that group, we're active there too. So yeah, let's try to not get so stressful, so stressed with this, and try to keep our attention on other things. And you know, we can take this time to learn something new and enjoy the process. Can you sterilize, use bonsai soil?
You can. I mean, what I do sometimes is I put it into like a pasta strainer and I wash off the old soil and I reuse it for like seedlings or cuttings or to germinate seeds. But if you have an older tree in training, I would always put a fresh bonsai soil in there that's clean and filled with nutrients and is ready to go.
Okay, let's see. How come it is hard to find Fukien teas that are show worthy? Are there species that are new to bonsai?
That's a very good question. So I don't know if you guys know, but in some of our YouTube videos, you see a tree on top of a container inside the store. And actually somebody asked that on YouTube the other day, what kind of tree is that? Yeah, I thought it was a maple. So that's actually a Fukien tea, and that Fukien tea was 50 years old, and unfortunately it died. But Fukien teas are extremely hard to come by, show-worthy material. There's almost nothing out there to find. So that's why I kept that one on the container, because I can't find myself to get rid of it.
I don't know why they're not so popular. Like in the shows, you won't see them as much either.
I've never seen one in the show. No?
Maybe
we need to make a comeback, you know?
However, I do like them a lot. I love the little white flowers. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
I do find that they get insects quickly, though.
They really do.
So those are the ones that we always have to be spraying, like twice, because they will have insects.
Yeah, especially on the very tips, on the new growth, underneath the leaves, they're filled with insects constantly. It's really difficult to get rid of them.
Yeah, let's say, how do you think about the idea of presenting viewers' pictures to the community and maybe do some recommendations and evaluation on them? I mean, I guess that's like the Facebook group that we have. The Bonsai Supply, Bonsai Family is a Facebook group that everybody can join, and people share their pictures there, what they're doing. Like it's a supportive community, and we do interact as well. So yeah, if you want to show something, go ahead and join that group and we'll see you there. Okay, how do I water adenium after it has dried for a week? Just a little at first, then more after a bit, or what do you suggest?
I suggest you go to the online course, to the boot camp, just because watering an adenium, I can talk about it for the next hour.
Could be tricky.
It is tricky.
And it depends on many, many factors.
Yeah, and watering an adenium is one of those things that's just difficult to do, and it's mostly misunderstood. So go check it out, and then join me in the closed Facebook group of the adeniums, and we'll talk about it.
Mm-hmm. I think my Christmas cactus has the corona. Should I flush the soil? Oh.
Did he say his Christmas cactus had a corona? You're supposed to water them with water.
I don't even know how to take care of cactus, to be honest. Christmas cactus. Is it?
I don't know.
Is this a cactus you go for Christmas, right? Is that?
Maybe there is a Christmas cake. I don't know much about cactuses.
All right, let's see.
I really don't.
Oh, this is important here from Brit.
Who's Brit?
From Cleveland. And yes, your wife is beautiful. I like these people.
Brit.
I'm gonna write them down.
Brit, what are you doing in Cleveland? You're supposed to be in Florida.
Let's say hello for Canada. Hi, Trevor. That's awesome. We love Canada. We really want to come back. It is safe to have an adenium.
But when it's warmer, because Canada was cold.
Oh, I love them no matter what. Okay, so they were highly poisonous. An adenium arabicum.
They are. I'm actually covering that in the online class, the boot camp also. And also,
be careful with those.
Yeah, always wear protective gloves when handling adeniums, but there's three adeniums that are very poisonous. And I'm talking about that and how you can protect yourselves, and also a little fun fact about the poison itself. So
yeah,
check it out.
All right, let's see. I'm gonna read on to this question. I see we're talking a lot. Okay, let's see. I have to repot my ficus
bit one.
Can I do it now? Which soil should I use?
That depends on where you are. Repotting tropicals, I always wait until the middle of the summer to repot them. In Florida, you can of course start after February, you can start to repot them, but I still wait until the middle of the summer. For soil, I of course would recommend our soil, because I only know how to grow stuff in our soil. It's very straightforward. Lava rock, pumice, calcined clay, and pine bark. As I mentioned earlier, we're sold out of the 5-gallon bags on our Amazon page, but they are now available on the Etsy page, and you can get to it through our website.
Okay, and okay, would it be worth setting up one room in my house dedicated to bonsais with grow lights, or just continue to use my balcony outdoors for my bonsais?
Outdoors is always better if you grow your trees outdoors. Just once you move your trees indoors, you're going to have complications. Of course, it depends on your climate and what type of trees you have. But if you have to grow them indoors, it would probably be good if you dedicated a room to your trees with grow lights. Just make sure you have a fan in there to circulate the air. It's very important.
Yeah, I mean, you can use them also if you have like winter.
Yeah.
That's of course. A good time.
Yeah, we do recommend, especially for tropicals, move them inside the house and get like one of those clip-on grow lights, and that works very successfully.
Yes, and I'm gonna pick this one more question for today, and is any tips on growing for cypresses?
Any tips on growing cypresses? In Florida, we repot them, like we treat them like a deciduous tree because they are. We repot them in like February, and we defoliate them before and then just let them grow. In July, we defoliate them once again, because in Florida, the dormant period where all the trees dip into the dormant period, and we defoliate it again. Once you have an older ball cypress and you want to work more on the ramification, you can break the leaves in half. Just cut them in half and you get smaller leaves.
Okay, and I think that I'm gonna say that that's the last question for today. However, if your question was not responded, I invite you to join the Bonsai Supply Family Facebook group, and you can ask there and we will reply it, and if it's not us, somebody else will, because everybody is very helpful there. And I just wanted to remind you, we do have the online Bonsai Bootcamp open now, and they're only $5 courses, so take advantage of it. We really want to see you learning about dates, desert roses, and buttonwoods by three of these great guys. You know, this guy is amazing in bonsai, not in TikToks, but he's amazing in desert roses. Adam has so much experience with dates, and then whoever doesn't know Ed Trout, you need to like look him up now. He's amazing. He has 48 plus years of experience. So this is just great. And you also have the opportunity to interact with him over the Facebook group and ask all your questions. So if you have, you know, $5 to spare, go ahead.
Yes, definitely a bargain.
Yeah. Or join the styling class.
Fantastic price, yeah.
With Jerome this Saturday.
Yeah, join.
Two Saturdays.
Let's have some fun.
Yeah. Or all of
them. I would love to see your tree.
And especially, you need to go to Instagram right now at thebonsaisupply.com and participate in our giveaway. So we're giving 3 VIP courses. They include a one-on-one session, either with Jerome, well, one with Jerome, one with Adam, and one with Ed. We're going to pick 3 winners, and all you have to do is to post a picture of your jade, your desert roses, or your buttonwood, and tag the Bonsai Supply, hashtag stay at home and bonsai. All right, because that's what we are gonna be doing all of this time. And yeah, and you guys, we're all in this together, and we hope you're doing well and stay strong. We're gonna do this.
We're gonna get through this.
Yeah. Thank you so much for watching today.
Yeah.
See you guys next
time. Oh, the regular one. I need the music, please. All right, guys. It was fun. I'll catch you guys in the Facebook group a little later today. And I'll catch you guys next time.
Bye. Thank you, guys. Stay safe.